Yes, adore you all of the time.
I'd like to.
This is the recap to our MLCW matchup this weekend, Born as Ghost versus Danish Clanwar. Be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video to see the results of the war and some special shout outs at the end of the video. So here he comes in with the Lalo attack. Now it's a Queen Walk Lalo. Nemesis coming in on their number 5. Absolutely beautiful attack. 10 on 10 action. Shows how much complete control he has over this Ray. Look at the wall breakers getting let down. Breaking in at the 6. Wants the Queen to get into that 6 o'clock compartment to take care of the enemy King, 2 ADs, the enemy Queen, and some of the CC. So he also takes out a Wizzy Tower down right there. Now he's going to use 2 Rage on this Queen to keep her alive. The other Rage will be used for the Lalo part. He also has 3 Haste, a Freeze, and a Poi. Notice what he does with the Freeze. But here he goes, laying down the Rage, amping up the healing factor, making sure the Queen stays alive. Also amping up that DPS of the Queen. Had to take out that Town Hall right away so that it doesn't hold him back from getting the other part of this attack started. King going down at the 9. Gonna do a little bit of tanking for the wall breakers. Gonna distract the cannon. That way the wall breakers coming in at the 9 can get in there real quick and easy and break up that compartment so that the King can join up with the Queen. Now the Queen is taking out the Expo. Very nice. Here goes 1 test wall breaker going in there. The rest of them get let down. He has 2 more that he's just gonna use to break through a double layer of walls. Oh, now he's not gonna break completely through with the wall breakers, but it does soften it up a whole lot. There we go. Bam! Wall breakers able to soften up those walls. King Queen able to just wrap around and get to that second AD. Here comes the dogs on the far right hand side, taking out the Disco Inferno, going to move into the ADs. CC came out, he freezed the CC, the witches and the archers, and then laid down the Poi on top of it. Smart thinking coming up from our boy Nemesis, freezing the CC and then letting the Poi melt him away. But dogs still doing some nice tanking, pups being spawned, bouncing all around, taking out the trash. He also has some minions over there on the sides, and oh, Queen's still alive, gonna help take out this Disco from those streams of fire, putting more pressure down on his loons. But he has a good group of loons left, man. Just absolutely destroyed this Town Hall 10 coming up from our boy Nemesis. We also have another Town Hall 10 that got completely wrecked. I want to show that to you. Of course, we always got to show the 10 on 10s, man. They are spectacular. All right, this one coming in from Michelle. Some more 10 on 10 action. A Shattered Lalo right here. Got 2 golems, 17 loons, 2 dogs, plus 1 in the CC. No, 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 not 1 in the CC. Just going to have bowlers in the CC. And, of course, he got the Royals. 2 Rage, 1 Jump, 1 Freeze, 3 Haste, and a Poi. Now, I know this is not the best war-based setup for a Town Hall 10, but it's no doubt still a max Town Hall 10. But she's going to come in here with the Shadow Lalo. And the way she's approaching is coming in down this alleyway right here. Going to lay down a jump to get to the core, the enemy Queen, and the enemy CC, along with 2 AD. So a lot of value out of that kill squad. That's going to afford the loons and the dogs to get into the rest of the base and take it out with ease. Lays down the Poi for the CC, and the enemy Queen lays down the jump, get to the core, lays down the freeze for an Inferno, taking that out also. So yes, a lot of value out of this kill squad. And look at this Expo. This Expo is pointed down, so that's not going to be any pressure for the air part of a Rage. Now she got 2 dogs, a Rage, and 3 Haste left. So the Rage, of course, and the 3 Haste is going to be used for the loons. Going to come in from the 6 o'clock with the dogs, but great value out of this kill squad, taking out this whole left side quadrant, 40% into the base before even laying down the air part of the Raid. So here comes a dog right from the 6, another one from the 3, Wizzy right behind the dog, already starting the cleanup process. So here come the loons, gonna lay down the haste to quicken the pace. Expo was pointing down, so again, no pressure for the loons. The only thing that's going to really provide any kind of resistance is this backside part with the Wizzy Tower, the AD, and the Inferno, and 1 Expo. But that is it. Besides that, this is going to be done for shot up. More loons coming in from up top, lays down the Rage right there in the core, taking out the Inferno, also the Expo, Wizzy Tower getting dealt with, pups all around, taking care of the cleanup, and very nice job coming in from our girl Michelle. Like I said, we had 2 Town Hall 10 triples, whereas Danish Clanwar struggled with that. They came in with some attempts, but was not able to trip up any of our 10s with their own. All right, so that boy, worst player ever, came in with the same style attack for both of his attacks in war. Now, he came in with the Quad Lalo. As you can see, he's got 24 loons, some minions, three dogs of his own, plus one in the CC. The Royals, of course, a Rage, a Poise, six Haste, and a Skelly Spell. Now, he uses the King to funnel the Queen right into that 6 o'clock AD. Just going to take out the one AD. The other one is no pressure because right there on the outside, just going to drop a few loons on it to take care of it. Not able to get to the enemy Queen, but it's no pressure because he brought the Skelly Spell. That's why he brought the Skelly Spell. They're going to eat her up. So here comes the dogs and just going to spam the loons over here at the 9, clear up to the 12, lays down the haste, speed them right into the defenses. You got three more left, a Skelly Spell and a Rage. And take a look at this. This backside AD, very easily going to get taken out with some loon spawner. There he goes. Lays down a few loons, takes it out before it could take out the rest coming in from the 12 up to the 9. So, yes, very nice. And look at this. A Skelly Spell getting dropped with the Rage. Very nice combo. Eating her alive, just taking her apart so she don't put no pressure on these loons. Dog still alive, tanking for the rest of this backside. And there you go, man. Easy peasy. Coming in from our boy WP Easy, man. He, like I said, he came in with both attacks, brought in a six pack with this spam loon Quad Lalo. Very nice job, my boy, getting it done. All right, our boy Mysterio came in with the same sort of attack for both of his attacks in war. This Queen Walk Dragon, I highly recommend if you're able to do it, go ahead and use it. But notice the vulnerability. All four ADs grouped to one side. He sees that, and he's going to Queen Walk himself right into this compartment, take care of the enemy Queen, enemy King, the CC, and all four ADs with his very own Queen. He's got two Rage, a Poi, and the Quad Quake along with a Skelly Spell. The Quad Quake would get laid down right here. Open all that up. Also, soften up a lot of these defenses with the Quake. So a lot of value out of laying down those Quakes. So here comes the Queen. Going to wrap around the 3. Work herself down onto the 6 where she's going to take all that mess out. And then the Drags will come up top at the 12. Now notice he's going to lay down his King also over there at the 12. That way he can funnel the Drag. As soon as he gets that place right here. As soon as he gets set up. Here comes the Wizzy. Along with a King. Now, I would like to have seen a Wizzy right on top of that army camp because the King actually backtracks towards that army camp and he doesn't walk, keep on walking down towards the 9. But here comes the Drags. But for the most part, he was able to push the Drags into the core, but it would have been much more efficient if the King had walked down with the Wizzies, clearing all that trash out because a couple Drags do stray off. But here he goes with the Queen Walk, keeping her alive, takes out the enemy Queen, now focusing in on the Wizzy Tower. Got two more ADs and take care of. Got three more loons that he'll be spawning on the back end of the space. But take a look. The Drags over there straying off. There's a few of them straying off. That's due to the King not continuing down on his walk towards the 9. If he had placed that Wizzy down on that army camp, that wouldn't have happened. But still, a very nice job coming from our boy Mysterio. I'm not going to nitpick at it. Oh, look at this. He laid down the Skelly Pill or the Skelly Spell for that last and final AD just to soften up. Here comes the Queen to finish it off. And there we go. There you have it, man. Beautiful job coming from our boy Mysterio with this Queen Walk Dragon attack. I highly recommend you, Town 9s, to go ahead and try this out in war. Boy, okay, went ahead and redeemed himself from the Queen Walk issues that he had from the previous war. Take a look at my last video if you didn't get a chance to catch that. But here he comes with the Queen Walk Mass Hog attack. So he lays down a baby dragon over there at the 1. Queen will be coming in. And notice this, he has CC healers. So CC healers getting the benefit of the upgraded healers, healing her back up. So she's going to continue her way down on towards the 9. Now he only has 3 healers. And I think that's a good idea because you get the upgraded healers, but not if you're going to be taking on no more than 2 point defenses at a time because you don't want that much pressure on your queen if she's only got 3 healers behind her. Even if they're upgraded, if he had an expo on her, that might cause some problems unless you're going to bring another extra rage. He only brought the 1 rage, and I think he actually ends up using that on the hogs. So to take care of the king the king and the enemy queen along with the CC, he's going to go ahead and lay down a Skelly Spell. Do a little bit of distraction, lays down that king, take care of the enemy queen real quick, slap her up. Now it's just a dog in a CC, so that's no pressure for these hogs just sneaking right in at the 1 o'clock. Got 3 heals, and like I said, I think he's gonna end up using the rage on the Hogs has just powered them up in the core, take some of these high-profile hit buildings out right there with the Expo. More Hogs going to be coming in from the right-hand side and from the six. Here he goes. Got two more heals. Another one getting laid down right there in the core. Replenished and back up. One more left in the bags and save it for this other side, this left side right here, where there's a lot of Teslas popping up along with Wizzy Tower and that Expo. Yes, very nice job coming from our boy OK, redeeming himself with the Queen Walk. But like I said, three healers, if you're taking on 2-point defenses, you might be all right if you have a max queen. But if you're taking on more than 2-point defenses, you might want to bring an extra healer. But my boy OK showed us how it's done, man. Very nice job coming from that boy. All right, so our boy Sticky Cloud also brought the CC healers. I think our boy's OK and Sticky is trying to start his trend. So they got the CC healers. So three healers all together for the Queen Walk. But as you will see, not going to take a whole lot of pressure from some point defenses, not even the Expos on the Queen. But he lays down a Baby Dragon, also Wizzy. Queen is going to take care of the enemy Queen along with the CC. Going to lay down a couple Hogs to get the pull of the CC. So here comes the Poi right on top of the enemy Queen, slowing her attack rate down. Couple Hogs going down, pushing on into the core. Gets the pull of the CC. Got another Poi, lays down on top of them. Going to melt them away. Here comes a Rage. Got to lay down the Rage. Keep the Queen alive. Make sure that healing factor is amped up. Going to push the Queen on into this 10 o'clock or this 1 o'clock compartment, along with some Hogs to help her out. King will be coming in from the 9 o'clock, but notice what he's going to do. Lays down a few wall breakers, going to bust right in at this 1 o'clock. Hogs take out that 12 o'clock AD. If he hadn't taken that out, would have provided some real resistance to this Queen charge. If he didn't take that AD out, they would have took his healers out. So here comes the King over here at the 9, doing some funneling, going to take out some trash. Also get rid of the enemy Queen or enemy King for the Hogs coming in at the 10 o'clock. So a good group of Hogs coming in at the 11. The 10, heal goes down. Got four more Hogs left that he's going to spawn on the back end. Another heal get let down right over here in the core. Giant bomb goes off. No pressure for the Hogs, so they're right there in the circle, the ring of the heal. And then more heal or more Hogs be coming into play over here. I thought it was gonna be on the backside over here, but no, it's coming in at the 9 right there. But yes, very nice job. As I said, Queen not taking much pressure at all from these point defenses or any defenses for that matter. But yeah, very nice job coming from OK and Sticky, bringing the CC healers, something new that I have seen. But yeah, it's a good benefit because you get that upgraded healer, and they're coming in place of the what level fours that you might have had. But the upgraded healer is able to heal her up really nice. But yes, very nice job coming in from our boy Sticky Cloud. There you have it. There are the results. Born as Ghost coming out on top of Danish Clan War 84-77. So a nice 7-star lead coming in from Born as Ghost. We did it, boys. Still undefeated. Shout out to Danish Clan War, man. They just struggled a little bit. They had a rough war. Their 9v9 was a little rough. And their hit up squad, the 10v11, was just a little rough. Their 10s had a dip down on the 9s. Oh, just a little rough for you guys. But shout out to you. Hopefully everything goes well in your future wars. Like to thank you guys for watching. Oh, let's give a shout out. I almost keep on forgetting, man. We got to give a shout out to the Six Packers, man. They did awesome. So let's give a shout out to Dirty. Not Dirty. Oh, your boy Grim came up out of his slump. I did get a 3-star dip, and I tried to go for 11v11. Just got the 2-star, but I came up out of the slump. Oh, so it's looking. There's a glimmer of hope for you, boy. There's a glimmer of hope. So also we had, as far as Six Packers, we had worst player ever. Okay, Alex. Novin D Hema, woo, and Mysterio. Is there one more? Mysterio guy. Yes, no, that's it. But nice. Great job. Shout out to you guys coming in through for your clan, man, with the six packs. Oh! Talk to you later. Peace.